Now I will ask you a simple, very simple question. I hope that you will answer fast. It is a okay. I will say. So we have two squares with the same breadth. Then I take center, center, midpoint, midpoint. Then I go this. What is this? What can you say about this ring?
It's
proof. So I will wait a little bit more for the others to catch up. Those who fall. In the meantime, we can do the following. So I will take one square, then I will take another square anywhere. Then I will do the following. Then I take the midpoint of this segment. Midpoint, midpoint. And what do I see?
A square. Square.
Yeah. Almost. Try. Maybe, you know what? Maybe, so this is actually this is difficult. So you can simply draw the figure and remember the problem. Maybe sometime you will talk it and sometime later. And here I want you to think about another one. So we take this figure and then I don't know what it is. No, I know what it is. Then they will have a problem. This is to be proved.
What is it?
So again, to make the drawing simple. So I have two squares with a couple of squares. And then I draw two other squares. Using this and that. What is this? This triangle, and this is the first triangle is obtained from this initial point, from this one. If I take this one initial, then I draw squares and Where? So in a certain way, this 1B is the converse of 1A.
If I draw squares on the sides and diagonals,
We know that one and two are equivalent. This is easy.
Here was double, yes.
So this is okay. Then we know that if the vertices of this point coincide, then this is a square, then two. So we know that this we know. From three, we can derive two. This we can do. This is problem one. Problem one B. If we can have two squares, we prove that this is a square. Yes? Triangles метр под B. Точка D1 была построена. Сначала мы взяли точки А на С, построили точку P по B и C, а потом построили D1 по А и C. Так, чтобы эти два треугольника, эти два квадрата имели общую вершину. Then it follows that the diagonal of the new quadrilateral are congruent and perpendicular. Тогда, потому что уже было заказано, мы знаем, что эти равномерные перпендикуляры. But then D coincides with D1, because for D we have the same property. Для D то же самое. Проводим диагональ перпендикулярно, откладываем равномерные перпендикуляры. Okay, so this story is finished, but the only unfinished part of this, which is very interesting, you can actually, you can, this is, here we have a kind of stronger statement. For example, if we take two squares, one square and any other square, I don't know, like this, and then we draw, for example, equilateral triangles. Можем взять любые два квадрата и построить вот так на соответственных вершинах правильные треугольники. И потом возьмем вершины, там нет ничего, конечно, потом возьмем вершины. Sometimes.